So Elektra Records sends Nico to me. She was part of the Velvet Underground.
Here she comes.
And I liked the Velvet Underground, but I really didn't know much about her personally, other than she was in a lot of Fellini films. I used to see her, and she was starkly beautiful, big Germanic glamazon. And I liked her right away. She came in, she was straight, she wasn't high, and came in and looked me right in the face and let's take pictures. So I took this picture of her. I just saw it immediately what I wanted to do. Out of this dark background comes these incredible eyes and her gaunt cheekbones and her amphetamine lips. They're all chapped from amphetamine use. And so when she came, I was thrilled because how often do you get to photograph a beauty? Many times you're trying to make people beauty, but here's a natural beauty, albeit sick. So I shot this cover, sent it to A&M, and they loved it. She was great friends with Andy Warhol. Andy Warhol loved it. He did a giant blow up in his studio, full size. And so I was thrilled that it was accepted as a piece of art by Andy Warhol. It's the way I like to photograph women. Very direct and strong. A woman is a strong creature, not a supplicant. When I retired and moved to Spain, must have been 3 or 4 years later, I'm sitting in a bar in Mahon. Mahon is where mayonnaise comes from, Mahonnaise. And I'm sitting in this bar, the American bar. I'm the only one there reading the international paper, and this silhouette in black cape comes walking towards me like a ghost image out of the fog. No joke, out of the fog. There's no one on the street. I'm looking. Could that be? Nah, can't be. And it was Nico. She comes up to me. Guy? And I go, Nico? And she says, you got any drugs? No, Nico, you go to jail for 6 years here for just a joint. This is Spain. See you later. Boom, wandered off looking for drugs. And I never saw her again. So that specter stayed with me for years. Never saw her again. And then I know she died, prematurely, of course, not that many years later.